French girl here. I just moved into a smaller apartment, and as you can see behind me, this is the kitchen I have to work with. So here's the takeaway. If I can do it here, all of the stuff that I do in here, you can do it at home too. So tonight, I'm gonna show you how to make one of my favorite recipes that's really not French at all. Although it has a very French name, it's chicken cordon bleu. And why it's called that, I have no idea. I've looked up and researched, and apparently it's part of some cookbook found in the 50s and 60s, but it really has nothing to do with anything French other than the name. So I am making it right here, right now, a whole new version of it, a healthier, just better for you version, and it's poulet cordon bleu, and I'm making it French right now. So take a look at this still shot recipe video that I'm doing for you right now, and check out how to make the poulet cordon bleu. I absolutely love how sophisticated this poulet cordon bleu dish is without being complicated. So let's assemble our ingredients, really just a handful of them to make it way easy for you. And we'll start with our low salt ham. And low salt is just way better for you. And when you add your seasonings, it won't screw up the flavor of the dish. So it's really a perfect kind of ham. For cheese, I love Swiss or Gruyere. It's a nice hard cheese, so it melts slower, but you can use ready cut cheese sticks too. That makes it easy for you. We'll also need some panko breadcrumbs. It makes the outside of the chicken super crispy, so we are going to dredge this in some egg as well. A couple of eggs, just stir it up with a fork just so that it's nicely blended, and I'll show you how to do that later. Of course, we need our chicken, and make sure that it is a thinly sliced chicken. It'll make it easier for you to roll everything up together. So just a quick recap of our ingredients: ham, Swiss or Gruyere, some breadcrumbs, egg, and of course our chicken. Don't forget your pantry staples, the little bit of olive oil, and some salt and pepper too. Last thing you'll need before we start rolling our poulet is a cookie sheet lined with foil. This will be our vessel for baking our chicken, and make it really easy to clean up too. So while you're doing that, also set your oven to about 400 degrees so that it's ready to pop the chicken in when we're done rolling. All right, so step number one, let's season our chicken fillet with a little salt and pepper, and then we'll lie our ham on top, just a couple of slices just to have a nice thin layer, and then add your cheese stick. Don't add too much, because if you do that, then it's gonna make it really difficult to wrap up your chicken. And then start wrapping up by folding over two of the longest edges, and then the other two fold over as well so that you have a nice, neat little package of chicken. The best way to hold all your pieces together, which is important to do, is probably with a toothpick, but of course I forgot to buy toothpicks, so we're gonna have to use something different. And I have some baker's twine, which is really just as perfect, and you can just wrap up your chicken. It doesn't have to be any fancy technique or way to wrap it up, just as long as everything is tight and sort of folded on to each other and just really in place so that nothing oozes out. Quick note on baker's twine: don't pull a Bridget Jones and her blue soup and get some sort of colored string, or use something that you think you found in your house or apartment. Get something that's just natural, or like I have, just a natural baker's twine. It won't bleed, that's how they make it. And you can find it really anywhere. Most supermarkets have it, otherwise stores like Bed Bath & Beyond or Sur La Table or any of those kitchen specialty stores will have it. Ooh, yum, I cannot wait for this dish to come out. It's like a little present. There's all stuff inside. It's just super good. So now we're gonna dredge, and you're just gonna do four steps. Dredge it in egg, roll it all around until it's nicely covered. Panko, same thing, and then back to your egg, back to your panko. So egg, panko, and then put it on your cookie sheet. And then we will top it with a little salt and pepper. My salt and pepper blend is right there. Just a sprinkle on top just for a little seasoning. Make sure you get a little bit of olive oil on there too. The spots that the olive oil hits will make the crust nice and golden brown. And then throw a little on your pan too so your chicken doesn't stick to the bottom. Pop this into your 400 degree oven. 25 minutes, it's pretty perfect, but double check, make sure that your chicken is cooked through. It should still be a little juicy because you have your crust and your filling, so everything is just sort of keeping that chicken nice and fresh inside. Voila, here it is. That cheese is just melting. It's perfect. The chicken is cooked perfectly. It's nice and juicy and tender. It's really a great dish to make. And as you can see, only about 5 minutes. It didn't really take very long. Once you get your ingredients together, it's really an easy put together dish. Make it the night before, cook it right before you eat, or the morning of, you know, whatever your schedule looks like, and you are good to go for dinner.
So enjoy your poulet cordon bleu, and we'll see you next time on the French Girl's Guide to Food.